What does he mean he's going to be able to make it up to Sting?
I think he still wants to be friends with Sting.
You got to be kidding me. You really believe that? Well, I guess you would believe it. It's time for the Sting-Goldberg matchup.
This is going to be great.
We want to remind you that the very last Starrcade of the century is Sunday, December 19th in Washington at the MCI Center. Tickets will go on sale this Friday at the box office at Ticketmaster. Goldberg will be at the box office at the MCI Center from 10 a.m. to noon this Friday when tickets go on sale for the last Starrcade of the century.
You got to get there and see Goldberg in person. Up close. This man is huge.
That's very important news. Plus, we'll be at Little Rock next week for Monday Nitro. The Palace of Auburn Hills the following week for Monday Nitro. Denver on November 29th at the brand new Pepsi Center for Monday Nitro. And on Monday, December 6th in Milwaukee at the Milwaukee Arena, it's WCW Monday Nitro. Get your tickets at all these great locations.
Zane Breslov do a heck of a job.
He works hard.
Well, he's never in the office. You never know where he's at. You can't get a hold of him.
Because you're always looking for a handout. Here it comes.
The man.
Remember now, Goldberg, the first of two times he must compete here tonight, because later on, we'll finally get to the bottom of who's the U.S. champ in a Texas Tornado ladder match. Four men, Goldberg, one of the four, Scott Hall, the other one, of course, Bret the Hitman Hart, Sid Vicious, and I guess Scott Hall, as we've seen, is going to have himself a manager. And some security as well. And I don't know what they got planned for Sid Vicious or what they got up their sleeve for that.
But you bet on something. They've got something planned.
It could be anything.
They're not going to enter that ring without a plan.
Goldberg makes the long walk, as he is famous for now here at WCW. All the way from his private dressing room to the ring. What about what we just heard from Dustin Rhodes? Did you expect that?
No.
I mean, after the build-up of this guy, which obviously from what he said, the name of Seven, that he would come out here and say what he said?
Well, I think
the powers that be.
I think he's hurt because of his father.
I think it's much deeper than that.
I'll tell you,
these guys learn a lot better. They keep their mouth shut and do what the powers that be want them to do. They'll be a lot better off. Don't try to buck the system here.
I think with a lot of people, that is easier said than done, Bray. Now, here he comes.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent.
Goldberg, as we said, made the challenge to Sid Vicious for the I Quit match. And he and Sid Vicious, even though neither man is still alive in the tournament to crown a WCW champion, they will go to mayhem on November 21st in Toronto at the Air Canada Center, and they will square off in an I Quit match. And let me say this, if you joined us for Halloween Havoc, you know how brutal that was.
I'll tell you another thing, Vicious never quit. The referee stopped the match.
And Goldberg never quit either, even though the videotape from the doctor videotape, I think was from Sid Vicious said to the otherwise.
Well, regardless of what you think about that, Vicious did not quit. He didn't quit.
I know that. I agree.
So what kind of a match is this going
to
be?
And the only way to win is to have your opponent give up to say, I quit.
We could be in Canada a long time then.
But now, the return from the startling match that happened at WCW's Halloween Havoc. Sting and Goldberg go at it. The bell is sounding. The fans are waiting for this one. You can hear the chant of Goldberg as the two men hook it up. And Goldberg immediately hammers on Sting. Needless to say, Goldberg has been a man possessed, Brain.
Oh, he has been since he came here at WCW. And he's been jobbed. He's been pushed around by a lot of people. High brass. People think they know what to do with this man, push him around. Goldberg's done it all. He's won the world championship. He's not going to be pushed around.
We thought he won the world title at Halloween Havoc, and then he went on to win the U.S. title, and then lost to Bret Hart. Thanks to the outsiders. Thanks to Sid Vicious. And he said he's already got a little measure of revenge on Sid, but he's sent a warning. apron. Mickey J had turned his back, and Mickey J received a glancing blow. And Mickey J, what was he talking about? Apologized to Sting. And what does she have in her hand?
It's like it could be mace.
That's probably the, you're right, the mace that they sprayed on me.
It's not hairspray.
And Luger's trying to...
He's trying to stop her. Pull that thing out of her hand.
They sprayed Sting in the face with it.
We got the wrong guy. Yeah. You know, it could be one of those turnaround valves where the disinflamer don't work.
Yeah, did he get the wrong man?
Oh!
Sting blinded and then speared. Luger was very upset visibly that mace went off at Sting's face. At least that's the way he looked, but I want...
It looked to me like Luger was trying to get it away from her. You know, a woman gets her mind set on something, you can't stop them.
Well, I'm going to Sting, and it's coming down hard.